is Vicki David from the Windows Club. If you encounter Microsoft Store error code 0x00000000 on your Windows computer, then please watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions. The first solution is to run the Windows Store app's Troubleshooter. Right-click on the Start button and select Settings from the menu. In the Settings window, go to the System tab on the list on the left-hand side. In the right pane, scroll down to Troubleshoot and click on it. Now select Other Troubleshooters. Scroll down to the Windows Store app's Troubleshooter and click on Run corresponding to it. The second solution is to create a new user account. Right-click on the Start button and select Settings from the menu. Go to the Accounts tab on the list on the left-hand side. Click on Other Users in the right pane. Click on Add Account. Now, click on I don't have this person's sign-in information. The Create Account page will appear. Use this page to create a new account on Microsoft and you will be logged in through it. The third solution is to check proxy settings. Press the Windows key and R key together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command INETCPL.CPL. Hit Enter to open the Internet Properties window. Go to the Connections tab. Click on LAN Settings. Remove the check beside Use a Proxy Server for your LAN. Click on OK to save the settings. The fourth solution is to reinstall Windows Store using PowerShell. Search for PowerShell in the Windows search bar. Click on Run as Administrator in the right pane. This will open the elevated PowerShell window. Now, scroll down to solution number 5 in the original article. The link to it has been shared in the description section. Copy the command line mentioned there. Paste it in the elevated PowerShell window. The last solution is to restore your system to an earlier restore point. Search for recovery in the Windows search bar. Click on the option for recovery. In the window that opens, select System Restore from the menu. If it asks for administrator permissions, please click on Continue. The System Restore window will open. Select the restore point and keep Next. Proceed through the System Restore process to revert your system to that date's settings. Reboot your system. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club and write your query. We will surely answer it. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.